Praise the Lord.
Warusa.
Everybody, I said, praise the Lord.
Emayafe, warusa.
Your time of possibilities. And tonight, great possibilities will happen in every life in Jesus' name. Raise up your hand as we pray. Father, we thank you tonight. We bless your name. You cannot fail. You will not fail. Your people want something from you. They will get their miracle. They will get their healing. They will get their deliverance. They will get their salvation. Bless everyone tonight, Lord. Glorify the name of Jesus. We thank you because we know you have answered. In Jesus' name we pray. And everybody shout amen. God bless you. You can sit down. I'm reading to you from Genesis chapter 18 verse 14. Genesis chapter 18 verse 14. Here is the Almighty God asking you a question. As he asked Abraham and Sarah the question. And he's telling us tonight that with him all things are possible. And in your life tonight, miracles you have never seen, the power you have never experienced will come upon your life tonight in Jesus' name. Genesis chapter 18 verse 14. Anything you had for the Lord? The Lord was asking the question. And the Lord is asking the question tonight. Is anything you had for the Lord? Look at your condition tonight. Look at your need tonight. Look at the situation of your life tonight. And look at whatever problem you may have tonight. The Lord is saying, do you think anything is hard for me to do? He will answer your prayer tonight. He will save your soul tonight. He will deliver you tonight. He will heal you tonight. Tonight I'm talking to you on great possibilities through our God. Great possibilities through our God. When we say great possibilities, that means everything you can imagine. Everything you can ask. Everything you are telling the Lord. Oh Lord, look at my condition. No matter how great the problem. No matter the situation. Tonight, the Lord will rule the problem away.
We
are told in Ephesians chapter 3. Ephesians chapter 3 verse 20. Look at what the Lord is saying. He says, now. Unto him that is able to do. Our God is able tonight. I said our God is able tonight. Able to do exceeding abundantly. Above all that we ask or see. He says according to the power that worketh in us. That power is going to work in you today. Three things we're talking about. Number one, the great power. The great power. Number two, the great problem. Number three, the great possibilities. Three things we're talking about. One, the great power of our Savior. The great power of our Savior. You know, tonight, there's nothing our Savior cannot do. His name is Jesus, the Lamb of God. The one that came to take all our sins away. Is a healer. Is a deliverer. Is the one that rolls every problem away. And tonight he will roll your problems away. Tears will vanish away. Sorrow will vanish away. And there will be the manifestation of the power of God in your life tonight in Jesus' name. Number one, the great power of our Savior. Number two, the great problem in our situation. Look at your surrounding tonight. Look at your situation tonight. Look at the problem on the right, and the problem on the left, and the problems that surround you. But thank God we have somebody greater than your problem. And we have a power greater than your problem. And tonight, those powers, those problems are going to be removed in Jesus' name. Number three, the great possibilities of the supernatural. The great possibilities of the supernatural. Do you know the supernatural power of God is coming upon you tonight? I said, do you know that the supernatural power of God is coming upon your life tonight? It will happen. You take your miracle home. You take your healing home. And you take all the wonders of God home tonight in Jesus' name. Number one, I'm talking about the great power of our Savior. The great power of our Savior. Our God is coming to you tonight. He will save you tonight. He will forgive you tonight. He'll turn your life around tonight. He'll replace your weakness with strength tonight. I will never be the same again. Say it for yourself, I'll never be the same again. Say it so everyone can hear you, I will never be the same again. Look at something in Matthew chapter 19. Matthew chapter 19. They asked a question from the Lord, and he gave an answer unto them. Look at verse 25. It says, when his disciples heard it, they were exceedingly amazed. That means they were surprised. They were shocked in what Jesus had said. Now they said, who then can be saved? You're looking at yourself tonight. Look at how great my transgression is. How great my sin is. How great my burden is. How great my load is. And like the disciples, you are asking, who then can be saved? But then the Lord replied to them. In verse 26, Jesus beheld them and said unto them, with men this is impossible, but with God all things are possible. Somebody there shout amen. He asked a question. You can expand that question. We can build on that question. We can investigate that question. Who then can be saved? Looking at how bad situations are. And looking at how defiled many people are. And looking at the habits that bind us. You ask him, who then can be saved? Who then can be transformed? We're so used to doing evil. We're so used to going in the wrong direction. We're so used to being in darkness. I say, who then can be transformed? The power of God is here tonight to save you. The power of God is here tonight to transform your life. You look at your condition, and you have made up your mind, and you been taking resolutions before. I want to change. There's no change. We tried many things. I want to change. But there's no change. And now you're asking yourself, if I tried everything I could, I've gone everywhere I could, I've attempted everything I could, and there was no change. And there's no transformation. And then you're asking, who then can be changed? And the Lord is saying, with the natural man this is impossible, but not with God. Because tonight, with our God who saves, a God who redeems, a God who transforms lives, a God who can change every situation in your life, with our God tonight, a change is possible in your life. you'll be bound for a long time. And you are asking yourself, without how terrible the bondage is. The bondage of Satan. The bondage of sin. The bondage of sickness. The bondage of satanic affliction. You say, who then can be liberated? I look at you tonight. I have confidence in the Lord. Tonight is your night of liberation. If you are asking, who then can be liberated? You are the one to be liberated tonight. Somebody shout liberation. That's why they were asking the question. Because human strength had failed. Human power had failed. Human technology had failed then. That they could not be changed.
But
God Jesus told them. He said, you can be changed and saved and transformed and liberated, and tonight is your night. Are you oppressed? Do you have any power that oppresses your life? And you are asking everywhere for deliverance. And there was no deliverance. And you are asking tonight, can I be delivered? Can I be delivered? I came to tell you tonight, your deliverance has now come. I said, your deliverance has now come. Blind can be healed.
A
lame can be healed. HIV AIDS can be healed. And whatever your challenge or sickness tonight, praise the Lord, your healing has now come. I said your healing has now come. Now point number two. The great problem in our situation. You see, sometimes the problem is so great. We don't even know to describe. And it is like you are in a dungeon. And you are so far down. And you look up. And there is no stair for you to climb. And you say, am I going to die in this dungeon? Thank God tonight, that situation may look bad. But tonight, God will do something in your situation. There's a man that had such a great problem. He was perplexed. He was confused. He had gone to the disciples of Christ that they will help him. But he could not have any help. And then with tears in his eyes, look at what he told Jesus. And whatever your tears are tonight, thank God they are wiped away. I said, thank God they are wiped away. Sorrow will go. Joy will come. Sadness will go. Gladness will come. All the body will go. He will lift you up tonight in Jesus' name. Look at the story of the man I'm talking about. It's in chapter 9 of Mark. At verse 22. Oftentimes it has cast him into the fire and into the water to destroy him. But if thou canst do anything, the man was talking to Jesus. He said, it's a perplexing situation. If thou canst do anything, have compassion on us and help us. Because he's gone everywhere, he had not got any solution. And the situation was very bad. Maybe that's your situation tonight. Now see, if anything can happen, please pray and let something happen. And the man said, Jesus, if you can do anything, have compassion on us and help us. Verse 23. And Jesus said unto him, And Jesus is saying to you tonight, am I talking to somebody there tonight? Miracle carrier, are you there tonight? The one that will receive healing, are you there tonight? Signs and wonders candidate, are you there tonight? Jesus said unto him, if thou canst believe, how many things are possible? Tell me out loud. All things are possible. Salvation is possible tonight. Healing is possible tonight. Deliverance is possible tonight. Miracle is possible tonight. Those blind eyes will open tonight. The deaf ears will open tonight. But they will rise up and walk tonight. How many things are possible tonight? I said, how many things are possible tonight? In your life, how many things are possible? In your family, how many things are possible? In your place of work, how many things are possible? While you're sitting or standing there tonight, tell me how many things are possible? Jesus said, only one condition. Just believe that God is able. Believe that Jesus is Savior. Believe that Jesus is healer. Believe that Jesus is deliverer. If thou canst believe, all things are possible to him that believeth. Thank God I believe. I say thank God I believe. All things are possible for you tonight. I see miracle coming your way there. I see testimonies coming out of your mouth. Because tonight, laughter, joy, happiness, testimony, all things are possible. Number one, the great power of our Savior. Number two, the great problem in our situation. Number three, and your miracle has arrived. I come to number three, and your salvation has arrived. Praise the Lord, you are a partaker tonight. Praise the Lord, you are a possessor tonight. Miracle carrier, where is he? What is she there? Possessor, what is he? Partaker, what is she tonight? It's going to happen to you. Point number three now. The great possibilities of the supernatural. Great possibilities of the supernatural. Look at, it's in Mark. Mark chapter 7. Reading from the start is 7. And they were beyond measure astonished. God surprised them with a miracle. The Lord was surprised with a miracle tonight. And they were beyond measure astonished. They were beyond measure surprised. They were amazed at what happened to them. Saying, he has done all things well. Did you hear that? He has done all things well. What does that mean? An afflicted man came. He said, I am free. He has done all things well. The blind man came and said, what are you talking about? Look at me. I couldn't see before. He has opened my eyes. He has done all things well. It was then another person came and said, what are you talking about? I was a captive. I was in the dungeon. And he came out and he said, he has done all things well. It was then another person, demon possessed, came and said, look at me, he has done all things well. And then somebody with epilepsy came and said, look at me, I am free. No more epilepsy. No more convulsion. He has done all six well. Tonight, he will do everything well. And look at the woman coming. And the woman said, if you saw me before I met Jesus, there was fibroid inside me here. And Jesus said, you are free, I am free. Somebody there, I am free. The fibroid was gone. He has done all six ways. And look at that woman there. I saw her an hour ago. There was goiter in the neck. But now I see her.
So when
Jesus has touched her.
Goiter
is gone. And
then
she also joined her testimony. And said, he has done all things well. My goiter is gone. And then somebody with HIV/AIDS. He came and he said, you know me, I went for test. They said it was positive. Jesus has taught me tonight. And Jesus has healed me tonight. HIV is gone. I didn't hear my people say amen. Look at the man coming. He had insanity. And now he said, look at me. I think well. I talk well. Insanity is gone. I am free. Because he has done all six well. And look at the man that is over there. And with all the sin, the mischievous things of the part inside him, God has removed everything. He said, I am free. The flame is rising up and jumping. And everybody is rejoicing. Rejoicing everywhere. And he says, he has done all things well. My lameness is gone. Tonight. Are you there?
Wherever.
Am I talking to somebody over there? Look at the person I'm talking about. Your lameness will vanish away. Oppression will vanish away. Rheumatism will vanish away. Satanic attack will vanish away. Typhoid will vanish away. And all the tuberculosis gone tonight. Because he has done all things well. All the people that try to wicked your life, tonight the Lord has taken away their hands. Yokes are broken tonight. I said yokes are broken tonight. That's why they all came. That's why you are coming tonight. I said that's why you are coming tonight. Look at that man there. He has a testimony. Look at the woman there. She has a testimony. Because he has done all things well. I said how many things has he done well? In your life tonight, how many things has he done well?
You are going back home with joy.
I said you are going back home with joy. There is salvation. It is yours. I said there is salvation. It is yours. There is healing. It is yours. There is deliverance. It is yours. Who is the candidate for salvation tonight? Please sit down, Bowed and eyes closed. Salvation is coming your way now. He will forgive your sin. He will take away the pain. He will take away the punishment. He is going to give you peace of mind. He has done all things well. He saves the young. He saves the old. He saves the man. He saves the woman. He has done all things well. You want the salvation of the Lord. You want the forgiveness of the Lord tonight. You want him to give you eternal life tonight. And you want to have the peace of God in your heart. Wherever you are, you raise up your hand. Wonderful. Raise up that hand. You want the salvation of the Lord. Tonight, Tonight is your night of salvation. If you are raising up your hand, you will stand up. You say, yes, Lord, I want your salvation. Raise up that hand and stand up. I want your forgiveness. He has done all things well. He does not discriminate. Everybody will have the salvation that wants it tonight. Whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. Who then can be saved? That woman standing will be saved. As you are standing, tell the Lord. Say, Lord, I thank you. Jesus died for me. He went to the cross of Calvary to die for me. I believe tonight that as I'm calling upon the name of the Lord, I am saved. My sins are forgiven. I am saved. Peace of mind has come to me. In Jesus' name we pray. Raise up that hand while you are standing and praying with you now. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for all our brothers and sisters, men and women, boys and girls, who want the salvation of the Lord now. They surrender their lives to you. They turn away from their sin. And they call you Savior tonight. Save them in Jesus' name. Forgive them in Jesus' name. Bring your peace into their hearts right now. Give them eternal life at this moment. Thank you, because I know you have answered. In Jesus' name we pray. And the people of God said, amen. Keep on standing. Our counselors are there. Counselors, tonight you have to be very fast. Keep on standing. Our counselors will get to you. After this counseling period, remember, I'm still going to pray for your miracle. He has done all things well. He will do all things well in your life. Shout amen. Our state overseer will take over now. Very brief a time we're giving to this counselor.
Counselors, please, let's get into the midst of the people quickly, quickly, and write down their names. You don't need to ask a lot of questions, just their name, where they stay. Please, the address, let's say this is Adolo Street. Is it Ugbowo? Please take note. We have Adolo in Ugbowo. We have Adolo perhaps in the Kewan or in New Benin. So you will specify. Is it Adolo in Oluku here? Please specify. When they say Ogwala, where is in Ogwala? Is it Siloko Road? Is it Sapomba Road? Please, let's put it down correctly.
Laho Adege Utumba Muwe also Wangwanwa.
Counselor, please, let's be smart about it. Our choir members, if you are joining, get inside. Please, if you are standing, the paper have not gotten to you, put up your hand. It's very important that we get your name, because we will get to you, reach you by phone or physical contact, to pray with you, to assist you. Please, if you are from the village, write the village that you came from. Is it the village around this vicinity or other villages? Write the name of the village. Maybe your house, there is no number in the village. Just write the compound or the area, how we can locate you. Please, let's be fast. If you have phone numbers, you will write down, you give them the phone numbers. Please, counselor, count those phone numbers. They are 11 digits. Let's be fast. God bless you as you are doing that. Please see if the paper has not gotten to you. Please wave your hand. You must receive. You have been here and the Lord has blessed you. You have stayed under the rain. The salvation of the Lord has reached you right now. The angels are rejoicing. The devil was laughing before. Now he's crying in one corner because you have left his camp. You have left the darkness. You are now in light. He can't get you. So please, this is a new day. You will never forget today. Give them your correct name, your correct address. Sometimes, the name you are giving, they don't know you by that name in your compound. Maybe you are Mama John, or Mama Jeanette, or Papa John, or Papa Osarime. Please put down that popular name they know you by. So I immediately will mention that name, they say he's here, and we'll get to you. Counselors, be fast. The supervisors, let's carry the basket. As they are writing it, we'll drop it, and then we'll need an information if you are finished. The overseer that are around, let's help. Let's quickly do that. By my right hand side, the middle, and by the left hand side, far back. Let's go there quickly.
Praise the Lord. That time has come. The time you were waiting for. He has done all things well. How many things has he done well?
A
miracle is coming your way. I said a miracle is coming your way. You have a testimony tonight. Something wonderful must happen. You raise up your hand for your miracle. And you
lift
the other hand of the place you have the problem. And then we're going to pray. Don't worry about mentioning the problem. Not mentioning the problem. The problem already, and the Lord is going to set you free.
It's
up that time for your miracle. When you hear the final amen, check up yourself. Lo and behold, it is done. Are you ready now? Father, in Jesus' name, you are the God of all possibilities. You cannot fail. You have never fail. Your love cannot fail. You love everyone. And your power cannot fail. The power is the same. Yesterday, today, and forever. And here tonight, that power is here. I set forth your power upon everyone in Jesus' name. Every yoke be destroyed right now in Jesus' name. Every problem taken away right now in Jesus' name. Command you, move out in Jesus' name.
Inhabiting their body.
And command, be healed in Jesus' name.
Problem,
I command you, come out in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray, definite miracle tonight. Signs and wonders tonight. Reach in every life tonight. I pray that impossibilities in every life will be turned around tonight. Make it possible. Make it possible. Touch everyone, Lord. Destroy the works of the devil. Those blind eyes open right now. Their ears open right now. Their tongues be loose right now. Your name, rise up and walk in Jesus' name.
Any eternal
problem, Lord, touch them. Heal them in Jesus' name. To the left, to the right, healing a miracle. At the back,
at
the front, healing a miracle. Everyone, man, woman, boy, girl, receive your miracle in Jesus' name. Jesus' name I pray.
Any Jesus, my Aneru.
Amen.
He said
it has happened.
Osunu neo.
I said it has happened.
Iwe osunu neo.
Check up yourself. You see your miracle. Wage
guage wa mi onginani ebani.
It is done.
Awen.
Is that the much you can clap for what God have done?
When you are setting purpose, you know saluba
wa. Amen. Please check up yourself. Our leaders, let's go in. Once your owner has taken, check up, Check up yourself. We don't tell lies in the church. Look at that problem you brought. That swelling in your private area. That swelling in your leg is gone. There's no movement now. We are going to listen to some people. Please, if you are true, the first one should start. Let's be fast. Let's be fast. Anyone that is true, let give him the mic.
Hallelujah.
Please, the usher should control these people, please.
Praise the Lord. I want to give glory to God Almighty for the wonderful miracle you have done in my life. Since the beginning of this year, my name is Bright Osayende John. Since the beginning of this year, I've been having this pain in my right hand side, and I went to the doctor and they told me that it's appendicitis. So I came here with a great expectation that God is going to heal me. So after the prayer and I check my body, I can't feel the pain again.
It's gone. Appendicitis is gone. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Oh, Lord. It will never come back again. Next. Our security men, don't let them come near the pulpit. We are giving testimony.
Praise the Lord.
Please face the crowd. Face the crowd.
My name is Okonkwo Yedika. I'm from Unipen. Pains and sickness have been taken away. I thank the Lord because I've been praying and for so long, since my childhood, different sickness is coming. But right now, everything is taken away.
Every sickness and pain has been taken away. You are
forever.
Healed in Jesus' name.
I thank the Lord for what He has done. I just thank the Lord for what He has done.
Amen.
Thank God for what He has done in my
Amen.
Life.
Amen.
Next one.
Go ahead. Your name.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Your name?
My name is Brother Godfrey Johnson.
Face the crowd.
My name is Brother Godfrey Johnson.
Go ahead.
So I have an attack on my right hand. I'm from Benin and I worship with Mountain of Fire Miracle Ministry in Benin. I came for this program and because I know that I'm believing God for something.
Yeah, what has God done?
And God has done me from an arrow that fire into my right hand. For some time now, and I pray He relieved me. That was sometime last year. And the arrow keep coming. It came about 3 weeks ago, and as it's paining me, where it is, and it looks as if it's, shocking my five finger. And as the man of God pray, and that continued about 3 weeks ago now, as the man of God pray, just now here, and I felt a relief, and the pain
It's gone. That arrow is gone.
The arrow is gone.
It's
and the
gone.
Hand that was
it's gone.
Me,
I say it's gone.
Again in
Praise
my
the Lord.
Yeah, hallelujah. God.
Next one. Arrow is crushed.
Praise the Lord.
Your name?
My name is Augustine Onyebula. I'm living at night. In fact, for over 4 years now, I'm having pain on my stomach. They say that they used to feed me on the dream. That is why I'm having that pain. Even before I came here, I say, since I've been hearing this man of God, I've never seen him live. I want to see him and witness.
What has happened now?
Today, even when I'm coming, I'm feeling the pain. But now, I don't even experience the pain again.
He's gone.
Praise the Lord!
Hallelujah. You will never see. Next.
Let
Mama first. Go ahead.
Praise the Lord. And I'm true today.
What will be your name?
Margaret Ifore. Master Ifore. My name's Margaret.
Go ahead.
So, my pikin they draw me, say, make I come. I know they did come.
As you now come, what thing can happen?
Because as I come so now, that they pray, say, everybody put one for where they pay now. Put one for my eye. With my chest.
Go ahead.
So mountain, I got to see what sort of they work out for here. Now, I got to take hand, they come out and see all that. So mountain, I can't open my eye. I can't see lights. I can't see people. Cray.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
This partial blindness is gone forever.
Oh, when I tell beggar say,
it's gone forever.
All we beggar say now.
It's gone forever. Mama, you go to see clear now forever.
All I beggar say now.
Praise the Lord.
Your name?
I'm lucky you're home, Bamu.
Go ahead.
Right from my childhood, I used to bed wet. My mother used to say that when he gave birth to me, I didn't bed wet. But when I grew up to some certain age.
What now happened as we came? Quick.
I bed wet at night.
Yes.
But not daytime. I was attacked by fire in my dream. So what, I was not hearing some noise.
What happens now?
I felt a sensation in me. Now something fell from my ear. So I had a strange feeling in me. Darling, I couldn't hear the noise, and I felt normal now. I'm feeling normal. I don't see any problem in my body again.
You are well.
I'm well now. I feel normal now. And I no longer hear those strange things in my life again.
That partial deafness is gone in Jesus' name.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
The next. Tell us your name.
Children of God, praise the Lord.
Your name.
My name is Justina David.
From where?
I'm from Sapley Road, Benin City, Edo State.
Go ahead.
I just want to thank God for how God has healed me this evening.
Yes.
I was in Abraka
attending
school. God has healed me for mental ill health. Because of this mental ill health, my husband left me. He said I had spiritual problem. He said that he doesn't know that I'm sick. He would have not married me. I've been like this. I've been in this sickness.
Tonight, what happened?
Tonight, God has healed me. I feel calmness. I feel coldness to my body. And I believe
mental
the man of God
prayer that I'm Jesus'
healed.
Praise
the Lord. I am healed.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
No more insanity. God bless you. Next.
Praise the Lord. My name is Miss Osarodio Mensi. I came here to testify that before I met her, but now I'm healed. Honre, Edo State.
Praise the Lord.
Honre.
Insanity is gone in
Praise
Jesus'
the
name.
Lord.
The next one, next, your name.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the crowd. Amen.
Praise Master Jesus.
What's your name?
My name is Love Eshego. I want to testify what God have done for me this evening. Before I came to this service, I was very weak, tired. I was not able to walk. All my legs were swollen down to my face. The hospital, they told me that I have a kidney problem, but I've been taking treatment. When I came, I wasn't able to walk. My legs were so swollen, I wasn't able to stand. But I want to give glory to God. Hallelujah. That you can see for yourself that my legs has come down. Is praise God. The Lord!
God. That kidney problem is solved. The leg swollen is gone. Next.
My name is Olamide Babatunde. I remember when Dad came, 2015. From Benin, Agen Junction. So I remember when Papa come. So Papa said, may we pray concerning pregnancy. And then I thank God for God. God give me baby boy. Thank you.
Praise the Lord.
Warosa.
The next. Yes.
I was having ear pain. As I came here, now my ear pain has gone. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. You are healed in Jesus' name.